Dear friends, welcome to the science class. In the last class, we started with the topic that is nothing but nutrition in the plants. In the last class, we discussed about the different modes of the nutrition, different type of nutrition. In the first few classes, we discussed about the autotrophic nutrition, that is nothing but the food of the plant is going to be prepared by themselves only. In the upcoming class, we started with the different modes of the nutrition. Different type of modes of the nutrition, that is nothing but we started with the heterotrophic nutrition topic in case of plants only. In the last class, we discussed about the parasitic nutrition. Parasitic nutrition in plants is nothing but the plants which they can't produce their own food are going to depend on the other plants. They are going to depend on the other plants for the purpose of the food. For example, we discussed the Cuscota plant. We discuss about the Cuscota plant, that Cuscota plant is going to climb on the host plant. Host is nothing but the plant which is going to provide the food for the Cuscota plant, or which is going to provide the food for the parasitic plant. The host is going to provide, the Cuscota plant is going to climb on the host, from where it is going to suck the food from the host because of the specialized roots. That specialized roots are nothing but sucking roots. Those sucking roots are going to suck the nutrients which are present in the host for the purpose of the Cuscota plant. This is about the parasitic mode. Parasitic plants. Next, we are going to discuss about the different type of mode. That is nothing but the insectivorous plants. Insectivorous plants, the second name, heterotrophic nutrition in case of plants is nothing but it is insectivorous plants. By the name only we can say that insectivorous plants are nothing but for the purpose of the food they are going to depend on the insects. They are going to depend on the insects. They are going to eat on the insects. They are going to eat the insects. Insectivorous plants. For the nourishment of for the purpose of the plant, they are going to depend on the insects. Those are nothing but the insectivorous plants. And for that reason, there are some plants which can trap insects and digest them for the purpose of their nutrition. First of all, these are the heterotrophic nutrients. We already know that. These are the heterotrophic plants. Why they are not going to prepare their own food? They are going to prepare their own food, but they lack in the nitrogen. The nitrogen which is going to provide the proteins to the plants, those things are lack in the insectivorous plants. For the purpose of the nitrogen, they are going to depend on the what? They are going to depend on the insects. So that insectivorous plants are nothing but for the purpose of the proteins, for the purpose of the nitrogen, the plants which are depend on the insects are known as insectivorous plants. So that these are the plants, which can trap insects and digest them for their nutrients. Now take an example. This is the leaf of the plant, insectivorous plants. What they are going to do, if some insects are going to come here and going to sit on that leaf or on that leaf, these are the specialized leaves. In that leaf, there will be nectar present for the purpose of the food of that insect. Insects are going to sit on this leaf. What they will do, they are going to capture it. They are going to close it. They are going to capture the insects. They are going to trap the insects by closing the leaf. Right, by closing the leaf, they are going to capture it. They are going to trap the insects, and after that, they are going to digest that. They are going to digest the insects for the purpose of the proteins. So that in this way, they are going to take the insects from insects. They are going to take the nutrients from the insects by trapping them and digesting them for the purpose of their food items. Right. If you want to see those things, so see more about the insectivorous plants, how they are going to take the food, you can check on YouTube by searching the mode of nutrition in insectivorous plants, how they are going to take animated videos, or they are going to show the live videos over there, so that they are going to trap the insects, or they are going to trap the animals, so that they are going to provide, or they are going to take the nutrients from those insects. Right. The same manner, these plants are green but lack in nitrogen. Already I told you, they are going to produce the carbohydrates by the process of the photosynthesis. They are going to produce the carbohydrate by the process of the photosynthesis. Green is these plants are green. Green means they are having the chlorophyll. What does chlorophyll do? Chlorophyll is going to grasp the sunlight for the purpose of the making, for the purpose of the preparing their own food. If it is grasping the sunlight, it is grasping the energy. That means there is photosynthesis is going to occur. If the photosynthesis is occurring, that means they are going to produce the starch or carbohydrates. Then why they are dependent on the insects? Why they are dependent on insects for the nutrients? For any plant, carbohydrates are not enough. For that purpose, they require what? They require proteins, if you remember the previous class. For the purpose of the protein, what they require? They require nitrogen. Those nitrogen thing is not present in the case of these insectivorous plants. Nitrogen thing is not present in this insectivorous plants. They have no source for the nitrogen. For that reason, for the purpose of the nitrogen, that is nothing but for the purpose of the proteins, they are going to trap the insects. For the purpose of the nitrogen, that is nothing but the protein. Right? I hope this is clear. They are going to prepare their own food as the form of the carbohydrate, but they lack in the nitrogen. For the nitrogen purpose, they are going to trap the insects for the nitrogen purpose. I hope this is clear why they are insectivorous plants. For that reason, insectivorous plants are known as partial heterotrophs. They are autotrophs only because they are going to prepare their own food. But due to the lack of nitrogen, they are dependent on the insects. For that reason, partially that is nothing but they are half autotrophs, half heterotrophs. For the nitrogen purpose, they are going to depend on the insects. Because of that, they are heterotrophs. For the purpose of the food, they are going to depend on themselves. Because of that, they are autotrophs. Because of this condition, they are known as partial heterotrophs. I hope this is clear. Now, how actually they are going to take their food? How actually they are going to take the nitrogen nutrient which is present in the insects? For example, they are given in the textbook. The example is nothing but, we have the example. One is pitcher plant, second is endive, third is Venus flytrap, fourth is bladderwort. Fourth one is a bladderwort. These are the examples for the insectivorous plants. So then how they are going to trap the food? That is nothing but insects. How they are going to trap those things? We are going to see those things. We are going to take the example of the pitcher plant leaf, which is shown in your textbook. We are going to take the pitcher plant leaf. The specialized name of the pitcher plant. It will be like this. I am going to draw those things. It will be like this. The tree, it will be like this, and this will be the lid. This will be the lid. Right? And this is the leaf. This is the leaf which is modified into the picture. Leaf modified as picture. After the maturation, the leaves which are present in the this pitcher plant are going to modify into what? They are going to modify into the leaf or specialized leaf or pitcher. They will be like this. Generally, this type of plants are called as Ujigida. In Kannada, they are known as Ujigida. Why Ujigida? They look like jug. They look like a jug. Because of that, the plant, leaves of these specialized plants are look like a jug. Very sweet leaf, because of that they are known as Ujigida. So they are look like that for that reason. And they have a leaf here and they have the leaf which is modified into the picture. How they are going to trap insects inside it so that they are going to absorb the nutrients which are present in that plant. In that animal. So that these have a specialized leaf. These have a specialized leaf. Those leaves are nothing but what? Which are known as pitcher. Which are known as pitcher. These are known as pitcher plants. And they have a lid here. The lid here. Right. When an insect comes inside this pitcher, when an insect when enters into this pitcher, this is pitcher, this will be the opening and this will be the closed one. When any insect which is going to enter into this lid, through this opening of this pitcher, the lid is going to close. When the entering of that insect happens, the lid is going to be closed. It is going to be closed here. When it is closed, insect is going to trap inside the pitcher only. It is going to be trapped inside the pitcher only, and then there is a digestive juices which are present inside the pitcher. Here there will be digestive juices which are present in the pitcher. Those digestive juices are going to digest the insect which is trapped by this leaf. Right? When insect enters, it is going to close. Juices which are present in the pitcher are going to digest the insect, so that they are going to intake the nutrients which are present in these insects. Alright, in the same manner, some plants are having the specialized leaf like this. They are going to have a specialized leaf like this, a open up mouth. Right? When insects come and enter into this, when insects come and sit on this flower or leaf, that this leaf is going to be get closed like this. They are going to trap like this. They are going to trap like this, and they are going to press those insects, and they are going to suck the nutrients which are present in these insects. So that in this manner, these insectivores are going to intake the nutrients which are required for the purpose of the nitrogen and nothing but the purpose of the proteins. I hope this is clear. Right. Next type of plants are nothing but cyclotropic plants. They are nothing but the cyclotropic plants. Right. Cyclotropic plants are nothing but, if you take the example of the bread, we are going to keep the bread in the water. We are going to put that bread in the water. Dip the bread in the water, and we are going to keep that bread for 2 to 3 days. Moist bread, we are going to keep it for 2 to 3 days. After 2 to 3 days, when we check that bread, there will be formation of the black coating on that bread. There will be the formation of the black coating, or cotton like threads will be formed on that bread. If you check on the ground in the rainy season, when you check those things, if you come across the, if you know that nycode, you come across the nycode, that is nothing but the mushrooms. Right, those are also black in color. They are not going to prepare their own food. Right, those type of plants, the plants which are grown on the bread mold, breads, after keeping for 2 to 3 days, right, the color level, black color or brown colored cotton like structures which are made on that flowers or made on that ground are nothing but the saprotrophic plants. Those plants are saprotrophic plants. Now what do you mean by saprotrophic plants? What will happen to the bread after 2 to 3 days when you dip that bread in the water and keep it for 2 to 3 days? Bread is going to decay. When it becomes decayed one, the dead decay material on which the plant is dependent, those plants are nothing but the saprotrophic plants. Right, so that you can say that mode of nutrition from the dead decaying material is known as saprotrophic plants, saprotrophs. Right, any plant which is dependent on the dead decay material are known as saprotrophs. So that generally we can say that the non-green plants are depend on the type of nutrition, this type of nutrition. Right. In this type of plants which are dependent on the dead decay matter are non-green plants. That means they are not going to prepare their own food. For the purpose of the food, they are dependent on the other being. That other building is nothing but they are dependent on the dead decaying material. For that reason, those plants are known as saprotrophic plants, and those type of organisms are known as saprotrophs. Right? In general, saprotrophs are nothing but they are dependent on the dead decaying material. Example for those things are fungi, mushrooms, yeast, bread mold, which is going to produce from the bread, mushrooms, nycode, if you remember, fungi which is forming on the dead or decaying food material which is formed on the decaying food material, fungus. Right, these are the examples for the saprotrophic plants. Next we are going to discuss about the symbiotic plants. We discussed about the insectivorous saprotrophy. Next is symbiotic plants. What are the symbiotic plants? In general, if I have to tell you symbiotic, what is symbiosis? Symbiosis is nothing but it is the relationship like husband and wife. What husband do? Husband work for the shelter purpose. Right? Husband works for the shelter purpose. Husband is going to work for the financial purpose of the family. In the same manner, what will a wife do? Wife is going to provide husband with the food items. She is going to prepare the food items like chapati, roti, those things. That means both the husband and wife together continuing their life by helping each other. One is helping by providing the shelter to the wife, another is helping by providing the food for the husband. Together they are doing the life. This togetherness is nothing but the symbiosis. The togetherness of the wife and husband is nothing but the togetherness. In the same manner, in the plants, they are not going to get married. That is the different thing. They are not going to get married and they are not going to have the life, the couples which are having. That is not the thing. They are just going to help each other for the purpose of their nutrient as well as the purpose for the shelter. So that symbiotic plants are nothing but sometimes two plants of different species live together. They are going to live together in the obtaining food and shelter. Like husband and wife, they are going to live together for the purpose of the shelter as well as for the purpose of the food. In the same manner, two different species of the plants are going to live together. One plant is going to provide with the shelter, another plant is going to provide with the what is going to provide with the food. For that reason, they are going to live together, they are not yet married. They are going to live together for the purpose of the food as well as for the purpose of the shelter. And this type of association is known as, is called as symbiosis. Symbiosis is nothing but two different plants together live for the purpose of the shelter as well as the purpose of the food is nothing but symbiosis. And such plants are called as symbiotic plants. For example, lichen and rhizobium. Rhizobium is a bacterium. Lichen is the plant. Right? If I want to illustrate these things, lichen on the symbiosis, on the association with the fungus and algae, it is going to have its food. Where fungi is going to provide the shelter for the lichens as well as the shelter for the algae. It is going to provide the shelter for the lichen as well as algae. Whereas algae is being a greenery plant, it is going to produce its own food. That food can be utilized by the lichens of the algae. Due to the symbiosis or due to the association of this plant, lichen is going to get its food. Right? Or fungus and algae are in association, both the association, algae is going to get shelter and fungus is going to get the food. In this type, they are going to live together for the purpose of the food as well as shelter. This is the different type. These are the four types of the nutritional mode in case of plant. First one is parasitic, second one is insectivorous, third one is saprophytic, fourth one is symbiotic. So be ready with these things. Next we are going to discuss about the another thing, that is nothing but last topic of this chapter is nothing but how nutrients are replenished in the soil. how nutrients which are required by the plants are replenished in the soil. So that if you remember the main requirement for the plants is nothing but the nitrogen. Nitrogen and nitrogen is obtained by the plants in the form of the soluble form, that is nothing but in the form of the nitrate. Right, every plant requires that nitrogen, and it is going to get it in form the nitrate, which is going to converted in the soil, which is present in the air medium, but it is not usable for the plants. So that plants are going to use the nitrate in the form of nitrate. For that reason, the crops are going to be produced. They are going to produce by using the fertilizers, which is rich in the nitrogen. In the same manner, we are going to use the manure. Now we are going to use the manure for the purpose of the nitrogen production, provision of the nitrogen for the these type of plants. Now what will happen? The crop plants which are rich in the nutrients, which are going to produce more amount of nutrients for the purpose of the human beings. So that while doing those things, they are going to absorb. So are going to absorb more amount of nitrogen. They are going to absorb more amount of nitrogen from the soil. That is nothing but crop plants. Crop plants require more amount of nitrogen. They are going to require more amount of nitrogen, so that they are going to absorb those things. Absorb nitrogen. They are going to absorb nitrogen. More amount of nitrogen in the form of soluble nitrogen. They are going to more amount of soluble nitrogen because they require for the purpose of the nutrients, so that when the plant is planted, it is going to absorb the nutrients. That is nothing but nitrogen which is present in the soil only. What happens when it absorbs more amount of the nitrogen which is present in the soil? The amount of nitrogen is going to get reduced. Because of this thing, amount of nitrogen is going to get reduced. Amount of nitrogen is going to get reduced. It is going to get reduced. Amount of nitrogen in the soil is getting reduced. That means the soil becomes lack in the nitrogen. The amount of nitrogen is getting reduced. That means the soil becomes lack in the nitrogen. When you try to plant another plant, or when you try to grow that plant, because of the lacking of the nitrogen, it couldn't grow correctly. Because it required throughout its life, it required nitrogen. If the nitrogen provided is not there, how it is going to grow? For this type of reason, due to the lack of nitrogen, there is a special type of bacteria which are present in the roots of that plant. Now, for example, nitrogen is present in the abundant amount in the air, but that nitrogen can't be used by the plant, so that the nitrogen which used by the plant should be in the soluble form. So that to overcome this problem, leguminous plants like pulses or dals, we can call it as leguminous plants, having leguminous plants on their roots, they have a bacteria known as rhizobium. Rhizobium is going to do that fixation of the nitrogen. That is nothing but the nitrogen which is present in the air is going to utilize by the rhizobium, and it is going to convert that nitrogen into the nitrate, into the soluble form for the purpose of the plants. What does rhizobium do? Rhizobium converts atmospheric nitrogen. It is going to convert atmospheric nitrogen to soluble nitrogen. It is going to convert atmospheric nitrogen to the soluble nitrogen. The bacteria which is present at the soil part, that is the root part, it is going to convert the atmospheric nitrogen to the soluble nitrogen. That soluble nitrogen is going to absorbed by the roots. From the roots, it is going to the again other parts of the plant. In this manner, the nitrogen requirement is fixed. The nitrogen fixation is going to happen because of the rhizobium bacteria, and it is going to provide the nitrogen to the plants. By providing nitrogen to the plants, it is getting the food from the plants. Since rhizobium is a bacteria, it doesn't make its own food. It is dependent on the plants for its food. And in the same manner, it is going to provide the nitrogen, soluble nitrogen, to the plants. In this manner, they are going to help each other. Rhizobium is going to help the to provide nitrogen. In the same manner, plants are going to provide the rhizobium with the required food atoms. In this way, leguminous plants are going to get the nitrogen. That's nothing but they are going to get the nitrogen, which is lacked due to the high amount of absorption by the crop plants, or high amount of absorption of the nitrogen by the plants. That fixation can be done by the rhizobium bacteria, which is present on the roots, which is going to convert atmospheric nitrogen to the soluble nitrogen for which is roots are going to absorb for the preparation of their food, and they are going to provide the food to the bacteria, that is nothing but the rhizobium. In this way, replenishment, or how nutrients are replenishment of that soil can happen. That is nothing but phalavatta, we can call it as. In this manner, the phalavatta or replenishment of the soil is going to happen due to the rhizobium. It is going to provide with the nitrogen. In the same manner, we are going to add the humus, we are going to add the manure, we are going to add the fertilizers in the soil, so that they are going to become more fertile land, and replenishment of the soil is going to happen like this. Here, your chapter completes. The first chapter completes. And if you have any doubts, you can ask. And we are going to solve the exercises in the next class. And we are going to take exam on the first two chapters. That is nothing but heat in this chapter. So prepared well. In the next class, we are going to discuss about the exercise questions up to that point. Thank you. Take care. Stay well. Stay home.